Namaste. In our continued bliss of enjoying Sri Krishna's names as in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, today we are going to see another interesting name. First things first, wishing all of you a very happy married life. Now, why suddenly a wish here? We will know through this episode. At the end of this episode, we will all look forward to having a very happy married life, right? So, today's name that we are going to look at is Jagatpate. Jagat and Pate, there are two terms in this. Jagat is one that keeps moving, or one which moves or changes, is what is called as Jagat. Pate, one who is the lord of such a place. So that is what we are going to see today. The characteristics of Jagat is defined in six steps. First and foremost, it has to be present, asti, as they call it. Let's take the simple example where in Sanatana Dharma, we believe that the Jivatma is eternal and it goes through the cycle of birth, death and rebirth, taking the body based on karma. So the fact that the Jivatma is present is asti. That's the first state for defining the Jagat. The second one is jayate. That means the Jivatma has to be born in a body. So that is the next state that we are called. So now we are seeing the change, right? The explanation of Jagat, we said one that changes. So asti, that means Jagat, the Jivatma is already there. The second stage is jayate, which is being born. The third characteristic is vardate, that means growth. We are seeing the example of Jivatma. So Jivatma is eternal, asti that we saw. Then jayate, which is takes a birth in form of a body. Let's assume it's a baby boy. And now vardate, the baby child has to grow as a boy and then as a youth and then as a man. So vardate. And the fourth one is parinamate. Parinamate is another characteristic for the Jagat. That means while the boy is growing, there are also different dimensions, different characteristics adds up. He is skilled, he is capable of doing a lot of things, he can multitask, a lot of different dimensions add to that characteristic. So, fourth characteristic is parinamate and fifth one is shayate. Towards, as we grow, as we age beyond 18, 90, we start shrinking. We can see people slow from their height, body shrinks, some also bend. So the shrinking phase is called Shrayate, and finally the sixth stage is called Mriyate, which is basically we can say death in this example, but otherwise just dissolving into this ether world. So these are the six characteristics of Jagat. Now, if somebody has to be a pati of this Jagat, should be a person who is not affected by all these things and who is able to govern these six stages. And who else it can be? It's Sri Krishna. So the Jagatpate is our Sri Krishna, one who commands over this whole Jagat and protects us by various aspects. So he gives a lot of protection. In fact, why he is called Pati? In common parlance, the husband is called as a Pati, right? And the nation's president is called Rashtrapati. So the Pati is a term given to one who is protecting, one who is able to give what is required without even asking in a timely manner, or even if it is asked, it is given. Sometimes we have to ask our own parents for certain things. So whether it comes automatically as part of a process, or if you ask and you get it, and being protected or giving the sense of protection is Pati. Sri Krishna is our natural Pati, right? He takes care of us. He ensures that we get every protection, everything that we need. We are given the right parents, right surroundings, everything that he is giving us. So in short, our Pati, this Sri Krishna, demonstrates four qualities. Rakshati, one who protects. Palayati, one who nourishes. As I said, gives whatever we want in this world. And Nayaka, he is our leader. He leads us. The example that I talked about, Rashtrapati, is our leader, leading the nation in various delegations, in times of crisis, in terms of representing this country, everything Rashtrapati does. Here, our Jagatpati is our leader. We look up to Sri Krishna for everything. We go by his Bhagavad Gita. We try to live as per his command, as per his instructions. And not, last but not the least, he is the Swami, the ultimate Lord. So these four characters makes Jagatpati Sri Krishna. If we use common examples of popular leaders, popular heroes that we have come across, they may fit in one or two, but they'll all have a limitation in something. A leader today cannot nourish us fully. He cannot be definitely a Swami. Who can fit all these four attributes is only Sri Krishna. So Sri Krishna is our Jagatpate. Now there are many instances in our Itihasa and Purana where Sri Krishna demonstrates how he is a Jagatpate. We all know Draupadi Vastraharan, how he protected Draupadi even by not being in the palace at that time. When Draupadi was insulted, he was there to protect. When Gajendra, the elephant, wanted help, he came physically and then removed the crocodile and protected the elephant. We all know the Prahlada Charitra. When Prahlada needed ultimate support, he was there as Narasimha, just there to protect one Prahlada. Like this, as Jagatpate, he is there to protect us at our call, as long as we call with faith, as long as we believe him in full.
Swayamevatmanatmanam vethatvam purushottama bhuta bhavana bhutesha deva deva jagatpate.
This sloka happens in 10th chapter, 15th sloka. So whenever you look at the time and time says 10:15, you know it is Jagatpate. How to remember Jagatpate? Just looking at our watch. Twice a day, we can remember him. Of course, 24 hours, if you remember him, he'll be very happy. Jagatpate, we can definitely remember at 10:15 every day, twice. So this sloka, you can actually observe that Arjuna uses five names of Sri Krishna, out of which three names, we have already enjoyed the explanations and all that. He uses the term Purushottama, Bhutabhavana, Bhutesha, Devadeva, and Jagatpate, the name that we are seeing now. So of which Purushottama, Bhutesha and Bhutabhavana we have enjoyed earlier. Devadeva we are going to look more in detail in chapter 11. Devadeva in simple, obviously Deva means the Lords. Devadeva, Lord of Lords, who is supreme, who is Sri Krishna. And in this episode, we are looking at Jagatpate. So in Jagatpate, as we explained, he is the Pati of this Jagat and Jagat that transforms. And it will be interesting to note that various devotees, Bhaktas, Acharyas, Alvars and Pandits wanted to get married to Sri Krishna. Come again, what is about marriage now? If our most Alvars, other than Andal, we are all men. How can men marry Sri Krishna? Is Krishna also not a man? So here the marriage is not about the body-to-body marriage that we are all talking about, where man and woman are required. This is much about spiritual marriage, where the Jivatma wants to marry the Paramatma. As I said, the body that I take today is based on my karma, but my Jivatma remains eternal. This Jiva wants to marry the Paramatma. How does it marry? It marries through the Acharya. That is why Acharya is very important in entire Sanatana Dharma. There are, in current day terms, of course, there are people who misuse this position or people who mock at this position. But without an Acharya, without a Guru, we can't even know who Sri Krishna is. And it is the Guru that who will lead us to Sri Krishna for an eternal marriage. And this marriage in Ramanuja Sampradaya, otherwise called Vishishtadvaita, Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, it is called the Bharanyasa, the act of surrender. As I said earlier in the example, Sanatana Dharma is very clear that the Jivatma is eternal. It takes the body in terms of birth, death and rebirth based on karma. And this cycle keeps continuing enormously. In earlier chapters in the same Namagita, we have discussed that Sri Krishna tells Arjuna, hey Arjuna, you take birth and I take birth. The big difference is you take birth based on karma while I take birth on my own Ichcha, my own Sankalpa. And the difference also is you don't even know what was your previous birth while I know what all births I've taken and what all birth I'm going to take because I'm taking on my own Sankalpa. So that means you and I as Jivatma, if we have been born for millions of years, we don't even know what was our earlier birth. We will be born for a few million more years if we don't perform the art of Saranagati. So that is what Ramanuja Siddhanta says through an Acharya, understand that Sri Krishna is the Supreme, which Sri Krishna himself is going to say in the 18th chapter 66 sloka, which we all know as the popular Charma sloka, surrender unto his divine feet and marry him. Because he is the Purusha. A Purusha, we said, one who can protect everybody and protect himself. We saw that in Purushottama. And he is going to be our protector eternally. And this marriage of Jivatma to Paramatma by the performance of Saranagati is extremely important. In that context, all of us are Naikas, are women who earn to be married to Sri Krishna. And this marriage is marriage of the soul, not of the body. Body is immaterial here. It is the Atma that matters here. And that Saranagati is what Jagatpate is insisting. We are in this month of Shravan, Purvapaksh in north and Puratasi in the southern part of India, where we celebrate every day, particularly the Saturdays, worshipping Tirupati Balaji. Now let us all surrender to the Jagatpate Sri Krishna, who is here as Tirupati Balaji, and be blessed with eternal marriage, and wishing you all a happy married life again. Namaste.
Madhava Achyuta Krishna Hare Rishikesha Keshava Govinda Vasudeva Bhagavan Janardana.